entrance hymn will be, "Lift Up Your Heads, Ye Mighty Gates."
Receive the risen Christ in the person of the Holy Eucharist. In preparation, we ask God's forgiveness.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You have seated the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who, as an example of humility for the human race to follow, cause our Savior to take flesh and submit to the cross, graciously grant that we may heed his lesson of patient suffering and so merit a share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Oh, regard equality with God something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness, and found human in appearance. He humbled himself, becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Let her alone. Why do you make trouble for her? She has done a great good thing. She has done a good thing for me. The poor you will always have with you, and whenever you wish, you can do good for them. But you will not always have me. She has done what she could. She has anticipated anointing my body for burial. Amen, I say to you, wherever the gospel is proclaimed to the whole world, what she has done will be told in memory of her.
Then Judas Iscariot, one of the 12, went off to the chief priests to hand him over to them. When they heard him, they were pleased and promised to pay him money. Then he looked for an opportunity to hand him over. On the first day of the Feast of Unleavened Bread, when they sacrificed the Passover lamb, his disciples said to him,
"Where do you want us to go to prepare for you the evening Passover?"
He sent two of his disciples and said to them,
Go into the city, and a man would meet you carrying a jar of water. Follow him. Wherever he enters, say to the master of the house, the teacher says, Where is my guest room where I may eat the Passover with my disciples? Then he will show you a large upper room, furnished and ready. Make the preparations for us there.
The disciples then went off, entered the city, and found it just as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover. When it was evening, he came with the 12, and as they reclined at table and were eating, Jesus said,
Amen, I say to you, one of you will betray me, one who is eating with me.
They began to be distressed and to say to him, one by one,
Surely it is not I.
He said to them,
One of the twelve, the one who dips with me into the dish. For the Son of Man indeed goes, as it is written of him. But woe to that man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would be better for that man if he had never been born.
While they were eating, he took bread, said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to them and said,
Take it, this is my body.
Then he took a cup, gave thanks, and gave it to them, and they all drank from it. He said to them,
This is the cup of my blood. This is the blood of the covenant, which will be shed for many. Amen, I say to you, I shall not drink again the fruit of the vine until the day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God.
Then, after singing a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. Then Jesus said to them,
All of you will have your faith shaken, for it is written, I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep will be dispersed. But after I have been raised up, I shall go before you into Galilee.
Peter said to him,
Even though all should have their faith shaken, mine will not be.
Then Jesus said to him,
Amen, I say to you, this very night before the cock crows, twice, you would deny me three times.
But he vehemently replied, Even though I should have to die with you, I will not deny you.
And they all spoke similarly. Then they came to a place named Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples,
Sit here while I pray.
He took with him Peter, James, and John, and began to be troubled and distressed. Then he said to them,
My soul is sorrowful even to death. Remain here and keep watch.
He advanced a little and fell to the ground and prayed that if it were possible, the hour might pass by him. He said,
Abba, Father, all things are possible to you. Take this cup away from me, but not what I will, but what you will.
When he returned, he found them asleep. He said to Peter,
Simon, are you asleep? Could you not watch for 1 hour? Watch and pray that you may not undergo the test. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak.
Withdrawing again, he prayed, saying the same thing. Then he returned once more and found them asleep, for they could not keep their eyes open and did not know what to answer him. He returned a third time and said to them,
Are you still sleeping and taking a rest? It is enough. The hour has come. The Holy Son of Man is to be handed over to sinners. Get up. Let us go. See, my betrayer is at hand.
Then, while he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived, accompanied by a crowd with swords and clubs, who had come from the chief priests, the scribes, and the elders. His betrayer had arranged a signal with them, saying, The man I shall kiss is the one. Arrest him and lead him away securely. He came and immediately went over to him and said,
Rabbi.
And he kissed him. At this, they laid hands on him and arrested him. One of the bystanders drew his sword, struck the high priest's servant, and cut off his ear. Jesus said to them in reply,
"Have you come out as against a robber, with swords and clubs to seize me? Day after day I was with you, teaching in the temple area, yet you did not arrest me, but that the scriptures may be fulfilled."
And they all left him and fled. Now, a young man followed him, wearing nothing but a linen cloth about his body. They seized him, but he left the cloth behind and ran off naked. They led Jesus away to the high priest, and all the chief priests and the elders and the scribes came together. Peter followed him at a distance into the high priest's courtyard and was seated with the guards, warming himself at the fire. The chief priests and the entire Sanhedrin kept trying to obtain testimony against Jesus in order to put him to death, but they found none. Many gave false witness against him, but their testimony did not agree. Some took the stand and testified falsely against him, alleging,
"We heard you say, 'I was destroyed in the temple and within 3 days I will build it up and I'll pay for it.'"
Even so, their testimony did not agree. The high priest rose before the assembly and questioned Jesus, saying,
"Have you no answer? What are these men testifying against you?"
But he was silent and answered nothing. Again, the high priest asked him and said to him,
"Are you the Christ, the Son of the Blessed One?"
Then Jesus answered,
"I am. And you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of the power and coming with the clouds of heaven."
At that, the high priest tore his garments and said,
"What further need have we of witnesses? You have heard the blasphemy. What do you think?"
They all condemned him as deserving to die. Some began to spit on him. They blindfolded him and struck him and said to him,
"Prophesy."
And the guards greeted him with blows. While Peter was below in the courtyard, one of the high priest's maids came along. Seeing Peter warming himself, she looked intently at him and said,
"You too were with the Nazarene
Jesus." But he denied it, saying,
"I neither know nor understand what you are talking about."
So he went out into the outer court. Then the cock crowed. The maid saw him and began again to say to the bystanders,
"This man is one of them."
Once again he denied it. A little later, the bystanders said to Peter once more,
"Surely you are one of them, for you too are a Galilean."
He began to curse and to swear,
"I do not know this man about whom you are talking."
And immediately a cock crowed a second time. Then Peter remembered the word that Jesus had said to him, "Before the cock crows twice, you will deny me 3 times. He broke down and wept. As soon as morning came, the chief priests with the elders and scribes, that is, the whole Sanhedrin, held a council. They bound Jesus, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate. Pilate questioned him,
"Are you the King of the Jews?"
He said to him in reply,
"You say so."
The chief priests accused him of many things. Again, Pilate questioned him,
"Have you no answer? See how many things they accuse you of?"
Jesus gave him no further answer, so that Pilate was amazed. Now, on the occasion of the feast, he used to release to them one prisoner whom they requested. A man called Barabbas was then in prison along with the rebels, who had committed murder in a rebellion. The crowd came forward and began to ask him to do for them as he was accustomed. Pilate answered,
"What do you want me to release to you, the King of the Jews?"
For he knew that it was out of envy that the chief priests had handed him over. But the chief priests stirred up the crowd to have him release Barabbas for them instead. Pilate again said to them in reply,
And what do you want me to do with the man you call the King of the Jews?
They shouted again,
"Crucify him."
Pilate said to them,
"Why? What evil has he done?"
They only shouted the louder,
"Crucify him."
So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas to them, and after he had Jesus scourged, handed him over to be crucified. The soldiers led him away inside the palace, that is, the praetorium, and assembled the whole cohort. They clothed him in purple, and weaving a crown of thorns, placed it on him. They began to salute him with, "Hail, King of the Jews," and kept striking his head with a reed and spitting upon him. They knelt before him in homage, and when they had mocked him, they stripped him of the purple cloak, dressed him in his own clothes, and led him out to crucify him. They pressed into service a passerby, Simon, a Cyrenian, who was coming in from the country, the father of Alexander and Rufus, to carry his cross. They brought him to the place of Golgotha, which is translated place of the skull. They gave him wine drugged with myrrh, but he did not take it. Then they crucified him and divided his garments by casting lots for them to see what each should take. It was 9 o'clock in the morning when they crucified him. The inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." With him they crucified two revolutionaries, one on his right and one on his left. Those passing by reviled him, shaking their heads and saying,
"Aha, you who destroyed the temple and rebuilt it in 3 days, save yourself by coming down from the cross."
Likewise, the chief priests with the scribes mocked him among themselves and said,
"He saved others, he cannot save himself. Let the Christ, the King of Israel, come down from the cross that we may see and believe."
Those who were crucified with him also kept abusing him. At noon, darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. And at 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out in a loud voice,
"Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani,"
which is translated,
my God, why have you forsaken me?"
Some of the bystanders who heard it said,
"Lord, he is calling him out."
One of them ran, soaked a sponge with wine, put it on a reed, and gave it to him to drink, saying,
"Wait, let us see if the Lord comes to take him out."
Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last. Sanctuary was torn in two from top to bottom. When the centurion who stood facing him saw how he breathed his last, he said,
"Truly, this man was the Son of God."
There were also women looking on from a distance. Among them were Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of the younger James, and of Joseph, and Salome. These women had followed him when he was in Galilee and ministered to him. There were also many other women who had come up with him to Jerusalem. When it was already evening, since it was the day of preparation, the day before the Sabbath, Joseph of Arimathea, a distinguished member of the council, who was himself awaiting the kingdom of God, came and courageously went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Pilate was amazed that he was already dead. He summoned the centurion and asked him if Jesus had already died. And when he learned of it from the centurion, he gave the body to Joseph. Having bought a linen cloth, he took him down, wrapped him in the linen cloth, and laid him in a tomb that had been hewn out of the rock. Then he rolled a stone against the entrance to the tomb. Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of Joses, watched where he was laid.
The Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Jesus raising his friend Lazarus from the dead,
and the Jews determined to kill him because of this, and Mary anointing his body with a very expensive perfume. And when Judas objects, and Judas, you notice, is the last mention during the soliciting of the apostles. Peter is first, usually. And back then, when people were executed as criminals, they were refused the customary anointing of their bodies after death. And so Jesus defends Mary then. He says, "Leave her alone. Let her keep this for the day of my burial." So Jesus is pointing to the future, and he says that this anointing really is the anointing they should get anyway. And then on Tuesday, Jesus again, the Gospel brothers again from St. John's Gospel, and Jesus at table with his disciples, and he's, you can imagine how sad he must be. He said, "One of you will betray me." And the apostles are absolutely shocked. This sounds impossible, that one of them would betray him. Who could it be? And of course it's Judas. And as Judas is mentioned last in the list of the apostles. And Wednesday, we call it Spy Wednesday, for obvious reasons. Judas goes to the enemies of Jesus, and he sells Jesus for 30 pieces of silver. Again, this reminds us of the Old Testament. Remember Joseph, dreamer, and he sold by his brothers, who despised him in his dreams, for 20 pieces of silver. And he later on will interpret the dreams of Pharaoh in Egypt, and Pharaoh will make him, put him in charge of all production, you might say, farm production. And he will save not only the Egyptians, but his own people and all the neighboring peoples as well. Jesus then will save the human family through his sacrifice on the cross, not just his own people, but all the peoples of the world. So Jesus is sold for 30 pieces of silver, the price of a slave. It's hard to imagine. And on Holy Thursday, Jesus anticipates the Last Supper, as we call it. He anticipates the offering that he will make of his life on Good Friday on the cross, the most savage, brutal, fear death of all. And he makes present sacramentally now, and commanded us on Holy Thursday night to continue offering the same sacrifice at the end of time. This, of course, takes place in the Mass. The Mass is so important. And the word Mass comes from, remember, the old days, ite, missa est. Missa est, you are sent to continue the offering you have made your church. And so Jesus continues then the offering until the end of time, the end of the world. And on Good Friday, Jesus goes to Calvary, as we saw in the Passion story, and gives his life out of love for you and to me, and for the salvation of the whole world. It reminds us that later on, in the final Passover celebrated in Jerusalem before Jerusalem was destroyed and the temple was destroyed, in the year 70 by the Romans, there were over 250,000 lambs sacrificed, and yet even that river of blood couldn't restore man to his proper relationship with God. Only the sacrifice of Jesus, foreshadowed by this offering, and all the sacrifice of the Old Testament could do that. So we thank God then, we ask God to help us to make this truly a holy week. If you turn to page 18 now, we'll have the blessing upon us. And it's the ushers will take him out to the foyer, and you can pick him up on the way out. Page 18 in the Missal. Dear brothers and sisters, since the beginning of Lent until now, we have prepared our hearts by penance and charitable works. Today we gather together to herald with the whole church the beginning of the celebration of our Lord's Paschal mystery. That's his death, passion, death, and resurrection. That is to say, his passion and resurrection. But it is to accomplish this mystery that he entered into his own city of Jerusalem. Therefore, with all faith and devotion, let us commemorate the Lord's entry into the city for our salvation, following in his footsteps, so that being made by his grace, partakers of the cross, we have a share also in his resurrection and in his life. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, sanctify these branches with your blessing, that we who follow Christ, the King, in exaltation, may reach the eternal Jerusalem through him, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark. When Jesus and his disciples drew near to Jerusalem, to Bethphage and Bethany, at the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the village opposite you, and immediately on entering it, you will find a colt tethered, on which no one has ever sat. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone should say to you, 'Why are you doing this?' reply, 'The master has need of it, and will send it back here at once.' So they went off and found a colt tethered at a gate outside the street, and they untied it. Some of the bystanders said to them, 'What are you doing, untying the colt?' They answered them, 'Just as Jesus told them to,' and they permitted them to do it. So they brought the colt to Jesus and put their cloaks over it and sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they had cut in the fields. Those preceding him as well as those following kept crying out, 'Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the kingdom of our father David that is to come. Hosanna in the highest.' We might join our decree. I believe in one God.
Look with mercy on the sick and their caregivers and heal them.
for all of the intentions on our parish prayer list and those intentions in our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sisters and brothers who died recently, that they receive the mercy of God and the promise of eternal life, especially for Sammy Boje, Brenda Vick, and Lisa Marie Lockwood. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to the murder in Myanmar and a democracy and freedom will soon be returned there, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that they would be able to free the Suez Canal soon and that world shipping will get back to normal. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our personal needs and for those who have asked us to pray for and those we promised to pray for, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we offer these and all our prayers and these into your Son Jesus. Dear Lord, help us to make this week a truly a holy week. Help us to ponder the mystery of your love for us and the love that is expressed in a special way in the suffering death of your Son Jesus Christ. And to keep in mind that the same Jesus is with us now, giving himself to us, present glorified in the Holy Eucharist. We make this prayer of grateful hearts to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Love is this.
Accepted unjust condemnation to set the guilty. His death has washed away our sins. His resurrection has purchased our justification. And so with all the angels we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Thank you.
therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Louis, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, especially Josephina Regalisa, and for the holy souls, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, My peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but in the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Meeting him would be when I surveyed the wondrous cross.
Oh,
getting them right now.
Join the concluding prayer, page 164. Let us pray. Nourished with these sacred gifts, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that just as through the death of your Son, you have brought us to hope of what we believe, so by his resurrection, you may lead us to where you call, to Christ, O Lord.
Amen.
Let's be seated.
There is no second collection this weekend. Thank you for those who continue to support Fatima Parish during these difficult times. Please encourage your children to donate to pickle jars to help the poor, especially during the season of Lent. Children learn by doing. Now is the perfect time as you come out of the desert of your Lenten practices to be freed from your sins. Fatima's Parish Penance Service will take place Monday, March 29th at 7 p.m. in the church. At least 9 priests will be available for individual confessions following a brief penance service masters still require in the church. The following is the list of Holy Week services. Holy Thursday, April 1st, 7 p.m. in English and 8:30 p.m. in Spanish. Good Friday services, April 2nd, 3 p.m. and 7 p.m. in English and 8:30 p.m. in Spanish. Holy Saturday, Easter Vigil, April 3rd, 7:30 p.m. in English and 10 p.m. in Spanish. Easter Sunday Masses, April 4th, 8:30 a.m., 10 a.m., 11:30 a.m., and 6 p.m. in the church and 10 a.m. in the parish hall. The collection on Good Friday is for the sacred places in the Holy Land. The second collection for Easter is for the aged and infirm priest funds. Envelopes will be on the tables by the collection baskets. We thank all those who have already turned in and filled in their CSA pledge cards with or without a payment. We encourage all parishioners to fill out a pledge card and send it to the diocese as soon as possible. This weekend is your last chance to order a lily plant for the decoration of the church for Easter. Fill out the coupon in the bulletin or a flower envelope found on the tables by the collection baskets. Include or attach a donation of $12 per plant requested. Put it in the collection basket, or bring it to the parish office on Monday, March 29th. Please take a copy of the bulletin home with you today. The information about the penance service, Holy Week, Easter Mass schedule is in it. Please don't leave bulletins or missals in the pews. And you may pick up the blessed palms and the vestibule of the church at any leave.
The Lord be with you.
And with you.
God bless, watch over, and protect you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I would encourage you to try to go to daily Mass now during Holy Week and to make this a special week to make it on Holy Week. As I said on Monday, in the Gospel, take it from St. John's Gospel, Mary anoints the feet of Jesus with the holy oil, the special perfume, the expensive perfume. And Monday evening here, we'll have the penance service with visiting priests. And on Tuesday, the Gospel is again from St. John's Gospel. And Jesus tells his apostles that one of them is going to betray him, and they're not ashamed again. Christ is Spy Wednesday, and Judas, the one who will betray him, goes to his enemies and sells him for 30 pieces of silver. Then Holy Thursday night, Jesus will give us the Mass, the sacrifice he will be offered at Calvary, that he makes present now sacramentally, and will to the end of time, for us to participate in Calvary now for our own lives and crosses and so on. And then Saturday night, we have the vigil of Easter, the vigil of the resurrection. And what happened to Jesus, hopefully it happened to all of us, that we will die and rise also with him. So God bless you, have a great and a holy week.
Our closing hymn will be, Were You There?